Authorities in Fiji have stepped in to secure the nation's tourism industry. This as recent international travel advisories call for caution amidst rising criminal activities. Rachel Nath filed this in-depth report.
It's at these famous seawalls of Suva that you are likely to find tourists watching the sunset over the city as the island's buzzing nightlife takes its form. But now foreign governments are calling on its citizens to exercise caution. Last month, the United States, New Zealand and Canadian governments issued travel advisories calling on tourists to remain alert in public places. These governments warned of several assaults, robberies and sexual assaults against female tourists occurring in Suva's downtown night spots, even calling for extra care while travelling in taxis. The Fiji Deputy Prime Minister and Tourism Minister William Ngavoka told us Fiji is safe.
Specific to certain areas in Suva. Otherwise, the whole country is safe, and our Prime Minister had gone publicly to say that this is one of the safest countries in the world. We respect what they have to do. They highlighted the fact that we should not worry because Fiji is firmly in level one, the lowest advisory for any country. Yeah?
Now, what seems like an alarming warning when placed into context for Kiwis simply translates to some risk. The government's official travelling advice website Safe Travel says a level 2 advisory cautions for slightly more vigilance than you would require when in New Zealand. Other Pacific tourism destinations for New Zealand, such as the Cook Islands and New Caledonia, are also grouped into level 2 security. For US citizens, this is the lowest advisory for safety and security risks, while for Canadians, it's a simple ask of taking similar precautions to those in Canada. Despite this, Fiji is taking heed. The Hotel and Tourism Association told RNZ Pacific they've raised their concerns with police. Chief Executive Fantasia Lockington says the warning must be taken seriously.
As an industry, we're trying to make sure that it's not allowed to continue to a point where it becomes too hard to roll it back. Raising our voices at a time to say, this isn't good enough. We need to make some changes now rather than when it gets worse.
Government ministers, the police and hotel operators are working in tangent to allay all concerns. Home Affairs and Immigration Minister Pio Tikunduandua told local media police will increase its presence through checkpoints around the capital.
The government heavy investment in 1,800 new police constables demonstrates our determination to address the existing police-to-population ratio and improve public safety.
Police visibility has increased and Police Chief Juki Fong Chu has doubled down that crime rate is dropping.
People are coming up with this perception, but you look at perception versus reality, the stats itself says it's a decrease. But police will continue to do its work in trying to manage and minimize whatever that is speculated out there by the general public and in the social media.
New Zealand travellers make up a big chunk, almost 25% of tourists to Fiji, and the hoteliers intend to keep it this way. When asked if an international security advisory could possibly smear the reputation of destination Fiji, Fantasia Lockington had this to say.
No, Rachel, absolutely not. Mm. The reason we raise our concern is that we don't want it to get to a point where that becomes an issue. So it's just being vigilant about things like this. And it might still be at very low level, but we can do something about that now before it has any sort of impact.
The government is also fully aware that protecting tourism is crucial for its post-COVID economic recovery. Deputy Prime Minister and Tourism Minister William Ngavoka is confident that they are doing just that.
Things are safe in Fiji. The numbers for the tourism numbers here are going gangbusters. You know, nothing has affected the demand for Fiji. Media, one of the biggest travel consolidators in the world, had carried out a survey and Fiji was top of the list. on the countries people want to visit.
Crime rates in Fiji has reduced by 7%, according to the Fiji Police Force.